So what do you make of Attorney Harry Roque's statements lately?
Several things, no? First of all, Attorney Harry Roque's
Wait, are you
credibility.
moving?
Yes, I'm moving. I'll stop.
All right,
but
okay.
first of all, I'm so sorry. First of all, Attorney Harry Roque's credibility in this particular issue is quite tainted for several reasons. The first one is, if you would recall, Karen, he is one of the persecutors of Leila de Lima when he was still a representative at the House of Representatives. Number two, he was the mouthpiece of the murderous Duterte regime. And in fact, and I quote the UP, University of the Philippines Executive Committee's statement against Harry Roque's election to an international organization, he has a very poor track record in defending and promoting human rights. That's first. Secondly, with respect to this particular issue, Senator Leila de Lima does not remember Judge Henerhito at all. If at all he was her student, there was no memory insofar as Senator Leila de Lima is concerned. Why? Because, you know, Senator Leila de Lima has taught hundreds and hundreds of students. And that's the reason why she cannot be expected to remember all her students. That's just really impossible, no? She has spoken in maybe thousands of forums as former chairperson of the Commission on Human Rights, as former Secretary of Justice, as former senator, and she cannot possibly remember everyone that she interacts with, including all her students. That's second. But thirdly, that's being a student is not even a ground for mandatory inhibition. And Harry Roque, as a lawyer, knows that for a fact. And, you know, hindi dapat nagmamarites ng mga ganitong favorite student, because that is casting aspersion on the credibility of a member of the judiciary without any basis. What is the substantiation of Harry Roque that Henerhito, Judge Henerhito, assuming that he was a student of Leila de Lima, was indeed the favorite student? What is the what's up with the adjective that he is adding, and what is his basis in doing so? If it does not have any basis for the word favorite, then that is legally actionable, because that is an ethical per our lawyer's oath and per the code of professional responsibility.
Okay, but is it true? Was Judge Hito ever her student? He issued a statement that he didn't go to San Beda.
Senator Leila de Lima has no memory that Judge Henerhito was her student, but you know, because she cannot remember all her students. This was like 20 years ago,
yeah,
or close to,
yeah,
30 years ago. So it is impossible for Senator Leila de Lima to actually remember all her students. As far as Senator Leila de Lima is concerned, she does not have any recollection of direct interaction with Henerhito as an individual. But, you know, it is not impossible, because Senator Leila de Lima has taught so many students and has spoken to in so many forums. But as to the word favorite, that is where we're taking an exception, no? Because it is very usual, Karen, for lawyers and students, or professors and students, to meet in court. Students, even of Supreme Court justices, even argue before them in the Supreme Court every time. So that is very normal. That's the reason why, per the rules, that is not even a ground for inhibition. But I confirm that Senator Leila de Lima does not have any memory, if at all, Judge Henerhito was her student.
Okay. And Attorney Harry Roque actually right now is campaigning for worse penalties for witnesses who recanted against De Lima.
You know, I don't know the motivation of former spokesperson Harry Roque, if this is genuine about our justice system, or is this again vindictiveness on the part of the Duterte administration and the likes of Attorney Harry Roque, who partook in the political persecution of Leila de Lima. No? Well, they have remedies available before the law anyway. But right now, can you imagine, Karen, 14 witnesses in total have recanted or want to recant, and their stories are clear. The story is that they were forced, they were coerced, they didn't have a choice, they were under the custody of the executive department. And if you would read the latest letter of the seven PDLs, they specifically stated that they were afraid for their lives because there was even a stabbing incident in the National Bilibid prison prior to them being forced to testify. No, we of course, we have to verify the genuineness of this letter that we've received. We have to verify their testimonies. But the facts are clear right now. And the truth is unrevealing itself. And the truth is the state has used in its entire machinery, coerced witnesses just to put a human rights defender in jail and a sitting senator in jail.
All right. Now, what is Senator Leila de Lima's plans? When I interviewed her, she says she hasn't forgiven former President Duterte and wants justice. She said it's a time of reckoning. But is there evidence to actually file a case against the former president? Because some have said the evidence may just be until the former Justice Secretary Aguirre.
Well, we're trying to investigate and evaluate all our remedies right now. Of course, we will never act if it's not going to be based on evidence. But, you know, in the rules of evidence, Karen, the biggest rule is those people who declare something against their interests or who admit things on record, that's the strongest form of evidence. And Rodrigo Duterte, even prior to the filing of these cases, has admitted on record several times his disdain towards Leila de Lima, that he will make sure that Leila de Lima rots in jail. And it's not just an accident that he is the president of the Philippines, the Justice Department is under his direct control and supervision. And all of a sudden, weeks after, all of these fake charges were filed against Leila de Lima. That is not an accident. Mm. It does not take rocket science to figure that out. So all of the declarations of the president, as noted by international human rights organizations, as noted by no less than the United Nations Working Group on Arbitrary
Detention. And they've been recorded. All his declarations are on record.
During official events by the Office of the President using no less than the presidential pulpit. Yeah. No? So that is a strongest form of evidence, which is why they were noted by the United Nations Working Group on Arbitrary Detention when they declared right from the very, as early as 2018 that the detention of Leila de Lima was arbitrary. No? So all of these things are recorded. So of course there will be a day of reckoning, and whatever the, you know, Duterte administration and the cohorts of Rodrigo Duterte would do, they cannot fool the Filipino people. They know for a fact that it was Rodrigo Duterte who authored the political persecution of Leila de Lima.
Okay. Will the former senator help the International Criminal Court? Have they reached out to her already?
There's no official communication right now from the International Criminal Court. But Leila de Lima, Senator Leila de Lima, is willing and able to assist in whatever capacity because she has already previously sent communication to the International Criminal Court.
Okay. Attorney Dino, I know she's out on bail, but with that, is she prevented from traveling abroad? Let's say she was asked to speak. Yeah, there were Western leaders, senators who actually supported and called for her release. There might be a university, an institute that would want to invite her. What are the conditions of the bail?
There are so many international organizations, you're right, Karen, that has invited Leila de Lima. Yeah. Universities have been inviting her not just to speak, but to teach as a professor to talk about human rights, the rule of law, the courage in fighting against despot, against impunity. So these are the most reputable universities, the most reputable international organizations right now.
Yeah. And, would you be able to share? I'm curious because you have a Nobel Prize winner, Maria Ressa, who will be teaching in Columbia University next year at the Global Policy Institute. I'm not even sure with the details, but I think she's a big inspiration for that particular division in Columbia.
I can just say for now, once, because we haven't received the formal invitation, but there has already been informal communication that these are the most prestigious universities you could think of, Karen.
So you have Ivy
League
schools.
Who would like Senator Leila de Lima. Yes.
Ivy League schools already inviting.
Of course.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Go on.
Just for the bail, no? Right now, based on once a person is granted bail, usually we still allow leave of court when it comes to these invitations. But Leila de Lima is never a flight risk. She has faced these charges right from the very start. She refused the advice of a lot of well-meaning people to just seek political asylum abroad.
Yeah.
If you would recall, when the warrant of arrest was issued, she was even abroad. And a lot of political leaders in the
And she came back.
She came back.
I forgot all about that. It's been so many years.
Yes, a lot of political leaders from well-meaning liberal democratic countries actually offered her to just seek asylum. But Leila de Lima said, I will face this because I am innocent. She had every single chance to leave, but she never did because she knows for a fact that she's innocent and she wants to face her accusers in the eye.
And where was she then? I mean, 7 years ago, just my memory. Where was she when a warrant of arrest was issued against her? Do you remember? The country.
She is in Europe.
She was in Europe.
She has a speaking engagement.
She could have sought asylum.
Correct. She could have easily.
Especially in Europe. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. But she didn't want to. A lot of her friends from the same from liberal democratic forces all over the world said, you can already stay. You don't have to come back. But she said she's gonna face her accusers in the eye because she's innocent and they're playing with the justice system and they are completely peddling lies. So that's the reason why she came back.
Yeah. Okay, my last question is a more personal one. We're showing video of Leila de Lima. Of course, you have the media following her home. And I wanted to ask you, for someone who was detained for 7 years, with no cell phone, no television, no internet, right? I mean, you have some VIPs who get detained, and frankly, they have phones. We know that. They get VIP treatment, they get visitors, they get great food. And here's Leila de Lima who says, no, I literally didn't have a phone. I was talking to the cats. No TV, we just had a movie once a week, so she was with the others. And no internet. She wasn't even allowed to discharge her functions as a senator, right? I mean, you had Senator Trillanes that was able to be a senator while he was detained, right? To act as a senator. How? I mean, you see Leila de Lima, she's smiling. Why is she so joyful? How is she so joyful and happy?
No, it's not just joyful and happy. For based on her own words, I was with her just 2 nights ago when we had a reunion with all the senatorial candidates of VP Lenny for the 2022 elections, just reminiscing what happened. Even though Leila de Lima was there, she was vicariously living through our stories. Her term was, I am exuberant. Why is it that she is exuberant? Because she knows for a fact that all the efforts and all the sacrifices she had were all not for naught. It was worth it. And at least she hopes that she is able to send the message that when people do the right thing, eventually they will have to trust that they will be vindicated. And Leila de Lima is on her way to complete at full vindication.
All right. On that note, Attorney Dino De Leon, thanks for joining me this morning. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Karen, and good morning to you all.